There is something that characterizes every Spanish landscape that makes it different from any other corner of the world. It is the sun, present almost 365 days a year, which warms the sand on its beaches, filters through the sea, and finds its way through the valleys. The sun that lights up its villages and cities. Spain is, without a shadow of a doubt, the country of light. This program is going to take a tour around some of Spain's most emblematic villages and cities. Art in Seville, avant-garde in Barcelona, the charms of Albarracín. Places in which the traditional and the modern live side by side in perfect harmony. The land of sunshine, Spain, today has a population of 48 million distributed over its villages and cities. A modern country that made its debut on the international stage with the Barcelona Olympic Games in 1992. Today, Spain offers avant-garde and functional cities that still maintain the spirit of their traditions. From north to south, from east to west, we also find villages full of charm that contrast with the hurly-burly of the big cities. Out of all of them, there is one that the ancient Greek and Roman historians used to call beautiful. A city located on a broad estuary, at the mouth of a river, in a charming natural enclave that made it unique from all others in these latitudes. They called it the beautiful Oayasso, and today we know it as San Sebastián. Situated on the Bay of La Concha, or Shell, its beach of the same name is one of the most famous in Spain. 1,350 meters long, and with an average width of 40 meters, it is a privileged stretch of sand at the heart of this city of almost 200,000 inhabitants. An ancestral city, every building in San Sebastián is a monument. The old casino dating from 1887 is currently the seat of the city hall. Orgul, whose name means pride, is another of the city's emblematic landmarks. On this promontory, covered by exotic and abundant vegetation, fortifications are preserved that in their day completely encircled the ancient city. On its highest part, the castle of La Mota rises to 123 meters above sea level. The Sacred Heart of Jesus keeps majestic watch over the city of San Sebastián, together with the island of St. Clair, located at the entrance to the Bahía de la Concha. At the opposite end of the bay, Mount Igeldo is another emblem of the city. At the top, the old casino with its characteristic turret is now an amusement park from which you get impressive views of the bay. The old funicular railway, inaugurated in 1912, still carries thousands of visitors up the hill every day. San Sebastian is a modern city with an outstanding, meticulous urban layout. Blocks of houses perfectly lined in quadrants are only broken by the spectacular natural topography of the area. The mouth of the river Urumea splits the city in two. On the right is the Andarreta Beach, smallest in the city, and the Kursaal Palace, headquarters of San Sebastian's world-famous International Film Festival. The old fishing port remains intact as a vestige of a city that has always been linked to the sea. With more than 8,000 kilometers of coastline, Spain is a land of contrasts. Its two seas, the Cantabrian and the Mediterranean, are examples of the differences between its coasts, cities, and peoples. In the 1920s, a small boy who loved art started doing drawings of his father's village, a fishing port called Cadaqués. Years later, he toured the world as a dedicated painter. He returned to Cadaqués to live and put this beautiful village on Catalonia's wild coast on the universal map. Numerous artists and intellectuals came at Dalí's invitation to discover the place about which so much had been spoken. Matisse, Picasso, Orson Welles, and Miró all came to soak up the light of Cadaqués. The Museum House of the Painter in the Bay of Port Lligat is one of the advertisements for this village in which everything is drenched in white. Created from a group of fishermen's huts that were purchased by Dalí and his wife Gala, it was opened to the public in 1997, and inside displays many memories of the painter. Cadaqués is meaningless without Salvador Dalí, just as the work of this brilliant Spanish artist is meaningless without the spirit of Cadaqués. Dalí also spent long periods in Barcelona. Here, he always drew attention to its stimulating intellectual environment. Today, Barcelona continues to be a reference for culture and the arts. And if Dalí were to take a look around, he would be pleasantly surprised to find one of the most avant-garde and modern cities in the world. The 1992 Olympic Games completely transformed a city that today looks out proudly over the Mediterranean as a reference for urban planning in Spain. With almost 2 million inhabitants, it is the second most populated city in Spain after the capital, Madrid. Its metropolitan area extends from the sea to the Colcerola Mountains, the lungs of the city and one of the largest urban parks in the world. Its most emblematic spot is the Tibidabo. Standing at 512 meters above sea level, it is the highest place in the city. The views from here are majestic. Above, the Temple of the Sacred Heart. This is one of the most outstanding examples of the 20th century Catalan avant-garde movement. Beside it, the Tibidabo amusement park is the oldest in Spain. Example of meticulous urban planning, every street and every square in Barcelona invites careful exploration. The Plaza de Catalunya is the heart of the city and a meeting point for locals and outsiders alike. Montjuïc, the old hill of the Jews, as they used to call it in medieval Catalan, is a compulsory reference point for the history of Barcelona. Fortress, castle, strategic lookout point, and city's defense, Montjuïc today is a park intimately linked to sport and leisure. Most of the Olympic buildings in which the 1992 Barcelona Olympic Games were held are here. Barcelona combines its most recent history with that which has given it global fame. The hand of world-famous architect Gaudí is present in every corner of the city. Güell Park is one of his most representative works from his later life, and one of the favored locations where Barcelona residents choose to go for a walk and enjoy some of the best views offered in the city. However, if there is one symbol of the work of Antonio Gaudí in Barcelona, it is the Cathedral of La Sagrada Familia, or the Holy Family. Started in 1882 by this brilliant architect, this overambitious cathedral, the culminating work of Catalan modernism, remains unfinished to this day. Gaudí's premature death in 1926 left the work with an uncertain future, given its huge structural and decorative complexity. They estimate that it will not be finished until 2030. La Sagrada Familia receives more than 3 million tourists every year, and is the most visited monument in the country. We leave Catalonia and enter the autonomous community of Aragon. Here, silence awaits us as, hidden in the foothills of the mountains, we find what many think of as the prettiest village in Spain. Albarracín, with its narrow streets, its walls, and its centuries-old houses, makes up a first-class historic artistic site. Its appearance, with ochre-colored houses, seems to belong to other, more peaceful and remote times. Today, Albarracín has a population of just over 1,000 inhabitants. Different civilizations lived here in the past, and the remains of many of these can still be seen today. Cave paintings from the Paleolithic era, Iberian sites, a Roman aqueduct, and the remains of Moorish buildings such as the Alcazaba and the Andador turret. Albarracín is located in an area of outstanding natural beauty and interest, with the Albarracín Range being home to the National Hunting Reserve of the Montes Universales. To the east, bounded by the province of Teruel, we head for another of Spain's great cities. Valencia, with 850,000 inhabitants, is the third most populated city in Spain. Valencia is filled with emblematic locations. Of all these, the most imposing is the Cathedral of Santa Maria, the most important example of Spanish Mediterranean Gothic architecture. La Puerta de Serranos is one of the 12 gateways that used to defend the ancient walls of the city of Valencia. It is a key reference point in the city of Valencia and one of its best preserved monuments. However, if there is one thing to recognize about Valencia, it is the harmony between the traditions of a 2,000-year-old city and modernity.
the street. I feel the cold of an old distant memory. Well, she left and he tried to stop the clock, find a way to wind back to the streets. It all began.
The City of Arts and Sciences, designed by the architect Santiago Calatrava, is today the emblem of an avant-garde city.
You'll finally learn the shape of your heart.
This impressive architectural complex is situated in the old riverbed of the River Turia, diverted in 1980 to prevent catastrophes such as the flood that took place in 1957 when the river overflowed its banks.
Now a woman, she knows who to blame. She sees his face and every man calls out his name.
The Queen Sofia Palace of the Arts is Valencia's opera house. The Prince Felipe Science Museum, in the shape of a dinosaur skeleton, is an interactive science museum with 40,000 square meters distributed over three floors.
The shape of your heart.
Lemispheric, with its curious eye shape, is the most characteristic building in the City of Arts. The Oceanografico, with a roof shaped like a water lily, is the largest aquarium in Europe.
One chance, you only get one chance. One chance, you only get one chance.
And the Agora is a covered square that holds concerts and sporting events such as the Valencia Tennis Masters Series. The Malvarosa Beach is an immense stretch of sand, more than 3 kilometers long, and the pride of a city that is blessed with a warm Mediterranean climate, with an average annual temperature of 18 degrees. Heading south to the province of Alicante, Benidorm is synonymous with holidays, leisure, and sun. From the middle of the 20th century, with its urban boom, it has been the reference for domestic and international Spanish tourism. No other city has such a large number of hotels, bars, restaurants, and nightclubs per capita. Its imposing skyscrapers, some of which are more than 180 meters high, are the typical profile of a city that has grown upwards. Its two beaches, Levante and Poniente, receive hundreds of thousands of tourists from all corners of the world, 365 days a year. Thank you. Benidorm is an example of a city that has arisen out of and for tourism. However, there are other places in Spain that grew up in ancient times as strategic locations during wars and invasions. Arcos de la Frontera, in the province of Cádiz, is a great example of the highland settlement so typical of this southern region of Spain. Built on the side of a crag, on the right-hand bank of the river Guadalete, the views from the top are spectacular. The historic buildings that comprise its magnificent castle, along with the Basilica of the Assumption of Our Lady, are one of the typical images of this village that is considered to be one of the prettiest in Spain. Every house here has to be painted white. Arcos de la Frontera is one of more than 20 villages that comprise the group known as the White Villages of the Grazalema Mountains. Our journey continues northwards, tracing the river Guadalquivir in search of a city that is pure art. Seville, with its 750,000 inhabitants, is the fourth most populated city in Spain. River Guadalquivir divides this unique place in two. On its right bank is the district of Triana with its famous bridge. On the left bank, its ancient historic center is the largest in Spain. They say that Seville is perfumed with orange blossom, and in spring, thousands of flowering orange trees impregnate the streets to create an impressive atmosphere. Its most representative monuments include the Cathedral of Our Lady of the Sea, with its world-famous Tower of La Giralda. This is the largest Christian Gothic cathedral in the world. UNESCO declared it a World Heritage Site, along with the Royal Alcázar Palace and the General Archive of the Indies. The Royal Alcázar of Seville is a group of palaces enclosed by a wall. This was where the members of the royal Spanish family would usually stay, as well as heads of state visiting the city. It is the oldest actively used royal palace in Europe. The Golden Tower, whose name in Arabic refers to its shining gold color that reflects the waters of the river, is another of Seville's symbols. A few meters away, we find the Real Maestranza Bullring. It is, along with Las Ventas in Madrid, one of the most important bullrings in the world. Originally built of wood in 1733, it is not completely round. Its 13,000 seats are not nearly enough for the evening bullfights during the April Fair, the city's biggest event. Everywhere in Seville, we find picturesque corners. Squares such as Doña Elvira or the Patio of the Flags in the Santa Cruz district are examples of the popular saying, "Here, all is art." To the north of Seville, we pass into Extremadura. The province of Cáceres is home to a beautiful town perched 564 meters high on a granite hillock. Christian territory since 1232, the defensive characteristics of Trujillo became more obvious due to the Muslim occupation. Its walls and fortresses comprise one of the most important historic monumental collections in the south of Spain. The walls of Trujillo are built of stone masonry with towers and battlements. It originally had seven gates, but only four remain standing today. The area within its walled precinct is known as the Old District of the City. The main square, which is rectangular and built in the Renaissance style, is surrounded by arcades. It is the best known place in the city and contains the famous statue of Francisco Pizarro, colonizer of Peru, who was born in Trujillo. Situated on the highest point of the city, the castle is one of the architectural jewels of this place, thought of as an open-air museum. Leaving Trujillo behind, we fly northwards over the Extremaduran countryside.
I wish I had a meadowland.
Salamanca, a university city par excellence, is one of the most beautiful of Spain's cities. Every year, it welcomes thousands of foreign students who come to perfect their Spanish.
I wish I had a spell of falling rain.
Salamanca is one of Spain's architectural jewels, resulting from the large number of monuments it houses. It is the only Spanish capital to have two cathedrals. The old cathedral, dating back to the 12th century, took 100 years to be built. The growth of the city made it necessary to build a larger one in the 16th century so that there would be room for all the faithful to worship. Built alongside the old cathedral, you have to go through the new one to visit the old. The main square, defined by the celebrated Spanish writer Miguel de Unamuno as an irregular quadrangle but astonishingly harmonious, is today the center of the city's social life.
I wish I had.
Salamanca is one of the jewels in the crown of Castilla y León, but not the only one. Flying over the spectacular Gredos Mountains, we are looking for one of the most surprising cities in the country. Ávila may be small in size, with a population of only 50,000, but it is huge in terms of artistic and monumental heritage. Its famous medieval wall, constructed in Romanesque style, completely surrounds the city. It is in a magnificent state of conservation, with a perimeter of 2,516 meters, 88 turrets, and 9 gates. It was built by order of the King of Castile at the end of the 11th century to protect the city. The wall that surrounds the historic city center, declared a World Heritage Site in 1985, houses monuments such as the beautiful Gothic Cathedral. Thank you. Raised up on a hill overlooking the river, Toledo has a spectacular appearance from any angle. Known as the Imperial City for having been the capital of the court of Emperor Charles I, and also called the City of the Three Cultures, as it has been inhabited over the centuries by Christians, Jews, and Muslims alike, Toledo breathes history through every nook and cranny of its streets. The highest part of the city is dominated by the Alcázar Castle, an ancient Roman palace dating from the 3rd century. Throughout the political, social, and cultural life of Toledo, it has been the city's historical reference. The Cathedral of Our Lady is considered by many to be the opus magnus of Gothic style in Spain. The locals know it as the Wealthy Lady of Toledo, and its 92-meter-high tower can be seen from any corner of the city. Historic center, such as the Gate of the Hinge, that dates back to Muslim times and was reconstructed in the Middle Ages. The image of Toledo from the air, with its labyrinth of small houses and uniform ochre hues, is impressive. Toledo today is the capital of the autonomous community of Castilla-La Mancha and is the ancient capital of Visigoth Spain. The capital of Spain today lies 70 kilometers to the north. Madrid, with almost 4 million inhabitants and 6,500,000 in its metropolitan area, is the largest and most highly populated city in Spain. The huge Casa de Campo Park, covering 1,700 hectares, is one of the largest urban woodlands in Europe, embracing the city on the west side and acting as the lungs for its inhabitants. Madrid has perfectly combined its urban development with green spaces, giving rise to numerous beautiful parks and gardens. The Retiro, the favorite park for Madrid's residents, has seen the city grow around it since 1640. Beside it, the famous Alcalá Gate is one of the most visited monuments in the city. However, another square and fountain represent the real symbol of the Spanish capital. The Greek goddess Ceres Cibeles in Spanish, on her chariot pulled by lions, was commissioned by King Charles III from the sculptor Ventura Rodriguez on his return from a trip to Italy. Astounded by the ornamental beauty of the Roman squares and fountains, he wanted to place Madrid on the same aesthetic level as other great European capitals. The square is furthermore the nerve center of Madrid's social life and a place for massive celebrations following the sporting successes of the Spanish national football team and Real Madrid. Right in the heart of Madrid of the Austrias, thus named in honor of the primitive medieval layout of the city and the urban expansion started by the House of Austria, as from the reigns of Charles I and Philip II, the main square is one of the other nerve centers of the city. With a design reminiscent of its namesake in Salamanca, the Plaza Mayor is a lively place at any time of day. Each square in the capital is a social melting pot in which Madrid folk and tourists meet to enjoy the characteristic terrace patios that are open all year round. The Puerta del Sol, the true nerve center of the metropolis and the starting point for the six main roads in Spain, is, in addition, the reference point for every Spaniard on the 31st of December. From its emblematic clock, the 12 chimes sound out to bid farewell to the old year and ring in the new at a party that is followed in every corner of the country. Spain's capital is also the epicenter of global bullfighting. The Las Ventas Bullring has played host to the most important bullfight events in the world since 1929. The festival of patron saint San Isidro takes place every May and brings together leading figures from the world of bullfighting to perform in front of 25,000 spectators from all five continents. After Mexico City, it is the largest bullring in the world. But apart from being a place that is proud of its history, Madrid today is a modern and avant-garde city. The Keio Towers and their strange inclined structure form the gateway to the financial heartland of the capital. An open and cosmopolitan city, Madrid is the capital of a fascinating country whose villages and cities reflect the spirit of its people. Charming villages lost in the depths of places that still preserve their traditions, monuments, and a culture that makes each one different from the next. From north to south, from east to west, modern cities, but overflowing with history, a combination that makes them twice as attractive for everyone. These are the villages and cities of this land of sunshine called Spain.
To koniec prymitywnego, organicznego życia. Trzeba stać się bytem wirtualnym, by wciąż pozostać między żywymi. Marzyłaś o tym. To nie jest nasza przyszłość, ale może być. Oto nowoczesne zmartwychwstanie. Nie masz do niej dostępu. Uciekaj stąd. Od prawdy nie da się uciec. Will? Nie możesz tego robić. Tak. Morgan Freeman, Rebecca Hall i Johnny Depp w filmie nie całkiem science fiction. To są ludzie. Przestań. Transcendencja. W sobotę 8 sierpnia o 20 w Canal Plus Film.
Między chorobą i śmiercią jest jeszcze miejsce na pozytywne zmiany. Bo pacjenci oddziału pediatrycznego nie zapomnieli o tym, że przede wszystkim są dziećmi. Bractwo Czerwonej Opaski w niedzielę o 17.30 w Canal Plus Family.
W pewnym gotyckim zamczysku mieszka niezwykły dżentelmen. Niestety nie wszyscy umieją docenić niezwykłość. Johnny Depp w kultowym filmie Tima Burtona Edward Nożycoręki. W niedzielę 9 sierpnia o 18.30 w Canal Plus Family.
Cudownym dzieckiem światowego boksu.
Bokserzy mało mówią.
Inspiracją dla milionów.
Jestem królem.
Był najgroźniejszym tancerzem ringu.
Mohamed znaczy godny pochwał, a Ali najwyższy.
Symbolem walki z rasizmem.
Kocham kolor swojej skóry i siebie.
Niezwykła kariera prawdziwego amerykańskiego herosa w filmie Muhammad Ali, legenda. W sobotę 8 sierpnia o 15.30 w Canal Plus. Słońce świeci tego lata dla Wikingów i dla dzieciaków na obozie w magicznej dolinie. Czekają ich lawina przygód. Wybuchowe emocje. I morze niespodzianek. Nowe odcinki seriali Viking Week i Na tropie króla lasu w sobotnie i niedzielne poranki od 9 w Canal Plus Family.
Wybrzeże Bałtyckie.
Primeval and wild. Some of its inhabitants come